have a theory. Hating someone feels disturbingly like falling in love with them. Your stomach twists and flips. Your appetite and sleep are shredded. Your heart beats heavy and bright, nearly visible through your flesh and clothes.
Can you please hold the elevator?
Sorry. Ooh. Already in motion.
Every interaction spikes your blood with adrenaline, and your body is barely under your control. This used to be the home of Gammon Publishing, known for its insistence on literature as art. Until a year ago, faced with bankruptcy, it was forced to merge with Bexley Books, an evil empire known for ghost-written autobiographies of brain-damaged sports stars. Make no mistake, the Bexleys and Gammons are at war. As for American Psycho over there playing the copycat game for no reason but to piss me off, yeah, hate him with a passion. I mean, sure, he's easy on the eyes, but don't let that fool you. As Shakespeare would say, sometimes fair is foul. My reasons for hating Joshua Templeman are several. One, I have never seen him smile.
Oh, hi. You must be Josh. I hear we'll be working together. Oh, I got you a plant for your desk.
Two, he's a total control freak. Just look at his desk. I mean, the guy wears the same shirts in the same order every week. Monday, dove gray. Tuesday, white. Wednesday, powder blue. Thursday, windowpane blue. And Friday, true blue. Reason number three, he always corrects any tiny mistake I make. Four, and perhaps most importantly, after the merger, he waltzed in with a list of people to fire, and it included all my work friends. Which were all my friends. So now I'm trapped here day after endless day, all alone with my one maniacal nemesis.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Has Bexley seen this?
I emailed it to Josh, so I'm assuming.
We're adding something at the top of the agenda.
Okay, do you want me to adjust it?
No, this is fine. I'd rather it be a surprise. Quarterlies?
On your desk.
How do they look?
Lower than projected, but they are better than Q2. And I talked to the marketing team about alternative print strategies, which I really think could help moving forward. And I sent you a memo about a company-wide team-building event that I'm planning.
But workers would rather eat rat skeletons than participate in group activities.
Agreed, but HR has been overwhelmed with complaints since the merger.
Half of which are about you and Josh.
Don't mind her. I don't know what I'd do without you.
Well, you'd be all alone with Satan and his hellhound.
See you inside.
Okay.
Lucy, I am so glad that I caught you. I was hoping that I can ask you for, like, a tiny favor. I need an extension on the monthly report. My new puppy ate peanut butter last night, and she's totally allergic. She put the poo in cock-a-poo, if you know what I mean.
Sure. Of course.
You're the best. I have it Monday, Wednesday at the latest.
That was pathetic.
Who is Joshua Templeman?
You know, Lucinda, you could just tell her to do her job, but no, you have to be the good guy.
It's a lot better than being the asshole.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Okay, come
Oh. You're
welcome. You want one? You remembered my birthday. Of course. Our little birthday turkey.
Yay!
Happy birthday.
Ooh, you know, I watched this insane documentary last night. 3 a.m., YouTube rabbit hole, history of baking. Did you know that Da Vinci invented the blender?
I invented pizza plate. It's the second pizza you put under your first pizza to catch the crumbs.
All right, can we please get started, or do you need another minute to chit-chat?
No, we're good to go. Oh, your tie's crooked.
Okay. Thank you all for being here the day before Thanksgiving. I know some of you are traveling, so we'll... Richard. So we'll try to keep this short.
Yes, and Friday after Thanksgiving will not be a paid holiday, FYI.
Okay, Richard and I have an announcement to make. We're adding a new position to the team.
Yes, we're going to be hiring a managing director who will oversee each department, and he will report to me.
He or she will report to both of us.
The job is open to external applicants, naturally, but I'd very much like to hire from within.
Yeah, we will be putting together an independent panel since we don't always see eye to eye.
The final candidates will make their presentations to the board after the new year. May the best man win. The job is mine, Shortcake.
Oh, your confidence is compelling, but you forget one thing. Everyone hates you.
Oh, they don't hate me. They fear me, which makes me effective.
You know, when I'm your boss, I will require you to do everything I say with a smile.
When I'm your boss, I'm going to work you so hard that you start using the office as your home address.
When I'm your boss, I will enforce casual Fridays. Wine shirts mandatory.
When I'm your boss, I'm implementing a new dress code. No more looking like an elementary school librarian.
If you get the job, I'll resign.
Really?
Just like you will if I do.
I don't quit.
Then I'll fire you.
Ah, but I'm incapable of giving you that pleasure.
Well, it's not the first time you've said that to a woman, is it? Then we agree. If one of us gets a job, the other has to quit.
Fine. Agreed.
Oh, hey, Danny.
Come bearing gifts.
Oh!
Oh, sorry. Should have waited for some eye contact.
A new book. That's so nice of you. Thank you.
Designer's got some advanced copies, so no big deal.
Oh, no. This is the cover?
Sorry. Bexley made us do it.
The book's about an archaeologist with autism. I mean, does he even read the jackets?
Doubtful. Oh, and this came for you in the mail, so I took the liberty to...
Oh!
0 for 2. Oh.
Me ordering your tiny clothes online again?
Just a box small enough for your withered heart.
I bet it's another Smurf.
Another Smurf? Oh, as in multiple Smurfs? So it's just like a Smurf village that you're putting together? Are you doing Smurf Army, Civil War reenactments?
Oh, she's got the whole collection.
How adorable.
Will you shut up? Thank you for the delivery, Danny.
Anytime.
Yes, Danny. Thank you so much.
Got it, JT. Well, catch you dreamboats on the flip. Hit it.
No.
Okay.
Bye.
That poor sap thinks you're flirting with him.
The same way people think you're flirting with me?
Shortcake, if I was flirting with you, you would know it.
I didn't know frat boys knew how to flirt. Thought they just roofied girls' drinks. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, I understand, but we're doing smaller hardcover runs? No. Same print run, just distributed differently. Sure. I will put you through to accounting. What?
Oh.
Richard, I have a copy of the new book for you.
Ah, hey. Dr. Josh, you didn't tell me it was in. Stripping time. Covers all me, you know. Really grabs you, right?
Yes, it's definitely eye-catching.
Yeah. You got my tea time set up for tomorrow, Josh?
8:30.
Good man. I gotta go work on my stroke. See you kids in the morning.
All right, good night.
Out.
Dick. stripping time. It's stripping time. This has nothing to do with strippers. I swear that guy's like the worst version of the worst version of himself.
Did you seriously just refer to the cover as eye-catching? Looks like it was designed by a horny fifth grader. Not exactly consistent with the tone of the novel.
Since when do you read the books we publish?
I was just trying to fill my Goodreads quota.
Oh, your one book of the year? You do know comic books don't count, right?
I fell asleep three times reading the first page.
Well, it is exhausting to read above your grade level. Maybe you're not ready for chapter books yet.
It was boring.
It was a masterpiece before Bexley cut 200 pages to make it more of an airport read. At least he kept in some of the landscape descriptions.
Oh, yeah. It was thrilling reading about the topography of Fort Ticonderoga.
Whatever. I loved it.
So big Thanksgiving plans? You're gonna be posting some Smurf fanfic and eating cranberry sauce out of a can?
And what about the Templeman family, drinking the blood of a virgin and then staring at each other in silence?
Oh, how'd you know? We're looking for donations.
Oh, hi, Jeanette. Oh, love those earrings.
Don't even try. Four complaints this week. Four. Three about the break room incident on Monday.
Go.
Are you ready for our lesson, okay? This is a comma, and this is a period. When you take a period and put it...
You better put that donut hole away or I'm gonna shove it up your semicolon.
You'd like that, wouldn't you, shrimp?
Mommy and Daddy fight sometimes.
We have discussions.
Like how Mommy constantly forgets to CC Daddy on company-wide memos.
Or how Daddy has a cork up his ass about the format of quarterly reports.
Mommy and Daddy, are you serious? You two are the worst part of my job.
Everyone else has left now.
There are literally millions of guys in the city.
Well, it's not that easy to find a good one.
What about that guy from work?
Who, Josh?
Honey, you talk about him all the time.
I do not.
I just worry about you all alone.
I know, Mom. I'm fine.
Well, we miss you, sweetie.
Yeah, I do too. Hey, look, Mom, I gotta go. I'm walking out the door. I'm gonna meet the girls for some drinks, but I'll call you tomorrow, okay?
All right. Love you, Pumpkin.
I love you too.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving. Happy Smurfs are all alike, but unhappy Smurfs are all unhappy in their own ways. Smurfette pondered this as she watched Grouchy Smurf squash a strawberry under his shiny boot, grumbling to himself about the unsmurfiness of the world. What's the occasion?
Psychological warfare. Time to get into his head.
Smooth, shortcake.
Shut up.
What is this?
Travel shot glass?
That would be a menstrual cup.
Right. My next guess.
What? These are better for the environment. And tampons are dangerous. You know what? No, this is none of your business.
Hot date tonight?
I might.
You are weirder than normal today. Pressure of the job application getting to you?
I had some weird dreams last night.
You had a sex dream?
No.
Was I in it?
Only in your dreams would you ever be in my dreams. Okay. Was a little erotic. I was in bed, naked, and there was a man pressing up against me. I could feel him, you know.
I think you're gonna have to spell it out for me.
Well, I guess I just feel weird because it is a guy from work.
Hmm? Hot date guy?
As a matter of fact.
Am I gonna have to notify HR?
We
are drowning in remainders.
We have more remainders of that insipid sports memo than we do of Jocelyn's book.
Because we print more, because they actually make money.
Because God forbid we actually invest in something artistically worthwhile.
You know what your problem is, Helen? You think it's below you to give people what they actually want. Me? I don't give a shit. People want a book on donkey farts? I'll ride the donkey all the way to the bank.
This is what I get for selling my soul to Mephistopheles.
Who?
Read a book, Bexley!
So, when and where is this supposed date going to happen?
You are very interested. Why is that?
Well, studies show when a manager feigns interest in his employees' personal lives, it boosts morale. That, and I think you're lying.
I am meeting him for drinks at the AC at 7, and you will never be my boss.
Well, what a coincidence. I'm going to the AC tonight at 7.
Fantastic. I will see you there. Oh, sorry. I should wear a bell.
Like a cow. You're not like a cow. I'm gonna stop talking. Hi.
Wait, are you moving offices?
I'm just doing a little pre-packing, you know, organizing my ducks.
Boop. What? No, you're leaving?
Starting my own company.
I cannot believe we are losing another designer. Bexley's killing us.
Well, I still have another week. what brings you to the Dan Cave?
Actually, I was wondering what you're doing tonight.
Oh, a couple guys are taking me out on the town to celebrate my old departure, but tomorrow I'm free as a beaver. It's not an expression.
Yeah, no, I'm gonna be swamped this weekend and actually all next week and the next week with this thing for cats, orphaned rescue cats.
Orphaned?
Yes, correct. It's kind of a big deal, and I don't really know when I'm going to be available again, so tonight is actually the only night I'm available for, like, a really long time, so.
All right. I mean, I'll switch things around, you know? It's for the cats.
Great. Awesome. You are the best.
You're the best.
Oh, the AC. 7 o'clock. I'll see you there.
See you there.
Were you just at my desk?
Thought I saw a spider.
What were you really doing at my desk?
Like I said, spider. You know what, Joshua? You are so...
sharp? Intelligent, superior in every way?
Predictable.
Still going on your date?
Yep, and I should probably get going.
You know, you should start with the virtues of the menstrual cup. Guys love that.
Yeah, I just thought I'd tell them I'm not wearing any panties. Do you guys like that?
You need a ride?
No, I will walk.
But it's pouring. I wouldn't want your makeup to smear after you just spent 22 minutes on it in the bathroom.
Has anyone ever told you that you have stalker-like tendencies?
Oh, so says the girl with the serial killer eyes.
Yeah, only when I imagine strangling you. God. Calm down. I'm not actually gonna strangle
what
you.
What are we doing?
What do you mean?
This. The schoolyard game that we play every day.
You mean the game where we hate each other?
Do you really hate me? Sorry. Just bump the button. So am I just taking you home, or...?
No. I need to go meet Danny still.
What are you talking about?
My date that you are driving me to.
Well, I thought... But Danny? Like...
Look, will you just pull over?
Hey, we're still a block away from the bar.
Yeah, I know. I really want to get out of the car.
Okay. Hold on. Hey, just wait a second. Go and take my umbrella.
Thing is, Harris, if this were an authentic log cabin, what you have to do is notch it out up here and then probably go with a classic A-frame for aesthetic and stability.
Hi.
Hey.
I'm so sorry I'm late. It's biblically torrential out there. Like I tried to fight off the tsunami.
You look great wet. I mean, you look really beautiful. I'm really bad at this.
I'll have a Johnny Black. Neat.
Bailey's. Rocks. Rough day.
Strange day. Oh, stripping time. Stripping time. You're reading it. What do you think?
You know, they say don't judge a book by its cover, but in this case, they're both god-awful.
Yeah, I know. I know. It's like, who wants to read 10 pages about the topography of Fort Ticonderoga?
Exactly what I thought. It's genuinely really bad.
Excuse me one second.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Hey, you all right?
I'm fine. What are you doing here?
You left your purse in my car.
Whatever. You win. The get in the other person's head game, okay? I mean, you somehow Jedi mind tricked me into kissing you when I should have just slapped your smug face. It's been a really good day for you.
What? I made a mistake, okay? And if you want to report me to HR
what?
Or...
That's what you're worried about? Josh, a man just called me beautiful, and my first thought is to think that he's messing with me, okay? I feel like I'm going crazy, so just please go home.
All right, we're going to see.
Hey. Hey, did I just see Josh?
Oh, yeah. I left work with a file that he needed, but don't worry, he is gone.
Hey, so are you and he, like, dying up? I just can't help but feel like there's, like, a vibe there.
Uh-uh.
You two.
Uh-uh. No. No vibe. No vibe there.
Cool. So... Like, this is a real date, then. I mean, it is, right?
Yeah. It is definitely real.
Awesome. So, where are you from?
Vermont.
Green Mountain State. Ethan Allen.
That's right. Yeah, my parents are strawberry farmers.
What? My parents have a hobby farm, too. I'm talking bees, goats, chickens, the whole thing.
Wait, are you serious?
I'm serious.
How did I not know this about you?
I don't know, but we got Karen and Sharon the sheep, we got Percy Pig, we got Benita the queen bee, and we got Philip the goat. You know about goat parkour?
Goat parkour?
That's correct.
No.
It's the greatest thing you've ever seen in your life. So Philip jumps off of any surface, pulling this like radical move where he's like, psych, I'm a goat. It's the best thing in the world. I have to show it to you.
Do you have pictures?
I don't.
It's okay.
A third of all our food actually comes from bee-pollinated plants.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Really, so.
Okay, so wait. Did you have to wear one of those bee suits?
To be honest, I'm like Macaulay Culkin and My Girl level allergic to bees. So every time I go home, I have to carry like an EpiPen.
No. Oh, that's so nerdy. I love that.
Says the girl who read War and Peace in the sixth grade.
No, I said I tried, and that doesn't make me a nerd. Okay, it just makes me precocious.
No, see, that's just nerd talk for being a nerd.
No, it's
embrace
not.
It. On the coastline in the water, your mirage is like a stalker. I should push him off the cliffside, cause he's coloring my insides ocean blue. And everywhere I look at you. It's true. Up in my imagination, I rehearse our conversations, and at least I'm never lonely, even though I know you're. Hi, who is it?
Lucy, I'm very sorry.
So sorry you forgot to shower this morning?
Can we please lay down our weapons?
Yeah, okay. Ceasefire.
Packing some heat?
Yeah. Comes strapped. Okay, now let's just never speak about it again, okay?
So, how was your date?
It was fine. Yeah, he actually sent me flowers, which I thought was a very classy move. Turns out we have a lot in common. He's really nice.
Yeah, the allure of the nice guy. Your white whale.
What's wrong with nice?
Nothing. That's what you want.
Isn't that what everybody wants?
So it seems. So, what game should we play now?
I don't know. About something where we don't fight all the time. Oh, like the normal colleagues game. It would go like this. Good morning, Josh. Why, good morning, Lucy. How was your weekend? Oh, it was lovely. Thank you. Oh, I'll be working on the Walker book today if you need any help. Oh, my gosh, that's so cooperative of you. You're very welcome, Lucy. Okay, well, I'll take that as a no.
Lucy, can we talk about your team-building proposal?
Sure. I booked the conference center, and I'm organizing a scavenger hunt. I made these tiny books, put little clues inside. It was kind of inspired by Gulliver's Travels, you know, Lilliputian books and... I'm sorry, do you have a better idea?
Well, as a matter of fact, I submitted a proposal of my own.
You did what?
Paintball. Physical activity, fresh air, and you come strapped, right?
No. That sounds like a lawsuit waiting to happen.
I felt the same way, but Bexley loved it.
Hell yeah, I love it. Let everyone work out their issues with guns and ammo like God the Almighty intended.
We flipped a coin, and we're going with paintball. I'm sorry, Lucy, I know how hard you worked on this.
You just couldn't let me have this, could you? Could you?
No problem. I mean, put down the books, nerds. Guns are the new... whatever's best for B&G, so. If you'll just excuse me a minute.
Tinkerbell on the rag.
Oh.
Bad date.
Attack, ready for battle. Carl, don't look so scared. Annabelle, nice muffs. What was that you were saying about everybody hating me, and yet here I am, leading a day of team building?
Oh, bully for you.
Oh, Lou's cute outfit. Oh. Look, I need a tiny favor.
Okay.
My boyfriend's niece is having a rough time. Drugs, legal stuff, there's an arson thing. But her mom thinks an internship would do her good.
No, I don't think now's a good time.
Look, I don't want to beg, but I'm totally going to beg. You're the only one that can deal with her.
Well...
just a couple months, okay? Thank you so much. You know what? I'm going to text her right now.
Oh.
You are absolutely the best.
No.
Luce, the best.
Hey, Luce, I've got this friend, and he's looking for a new roommate.
Will
you think you
want
to move
up
in with him?
Hey.
Oh. Pretty fancy gun you got.
JP Splatmaster 1000. This puppy goes 200 yards. No ball, chap. Hey, you want to be teammates?
Yes.
Teams are pre-selected.
All right. You know, if they're pre-selected. See you out there.
Oh, sorry.
Helmet.
This guy's a walking catastrophe.
Okay, easy, Tiger. It's his last day.
You look pale.
What are you doing?
You're burning up, Shortcake.
I do not know anyone by that name.
You sure you don't want to sit this one out?
Oh, no. No, I am not going anywhere. I am going to be right here, all up in your grill, like a 4th of July picnic. I am going to annihilate you.
We're on the same team.
Fuck.
All right, listen up. It's going to be two teams, orange versus blue. Capture the flag. Let's go.
Lucy, move out.
Go.
Okay, move. Take down Tumbleweed.
Go. Come on.
Go.
Watch out.
Parkour.
What? Don't you go dying on me.
Hi, Danny.
Fall back.
Get the shit out of here. Guys, Tumbleweed into the camper.
Shit. Save yourself.
Stop. Come on, Einstein.
Move. Move up!
Okay, team, what's the plan? Wait for a signal.
Wait, what? Watch the signal. Okay, I'll cover you.
Worry about yourself, G.I. Joe. The sniper's got us pinned down.
I got this, Lucy.
But what is she doing? I didn't signal.
Here comes the pain. You like that?
Yeah.
Stop my paintball, Satan! Son of a bitch!
Son of a bat.
knew I should have gone with the splat master.
Aw, poor Danny.
Mother of dragons, that hurt. Seriously? I'm already out.
Sorry. Was that really necessary?
All's fair in love and war. Okay, I'm gonna make a run for it.
And let you get all the glory? Hell no, Templeman.
Better act quick then, Shortcake. What are you doing?
You never bring cupcakes.
We're on the same team. Get off.
Go, Lucy, go.
Stay down.
What are you doing?
Get off me.
Total domination.
You hurt her. Oh, my God. Lucy, I'm sorry. I got carried away.
Stop it. Get this thing off me. It's like a million degrees.
Lucy, you're sweating. Oh, my God. Is it internal bleeding? Is she going to die?
No, she doesn't have a fever because you shot her, you dick.
Are you okay?
She's fine.
No, I'm fine. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Oh, God.
All right. Let's get you up. Come on. Time to go home. Yeah. The ball's over.
I'm sorry.
What are you doing here?
I drove you home.
No, I know. Why are you standing in my apartment right now?
Well, what do you think I was going to do? Just open the door and kick you out of a moving car?
I'm fine.
Yeah, okay. You going to be sick? Okay, bathroom, go. There you go.
Oh, the humanity.
Okay.
I can see it there, hidden in your crystal eyes, that it's hard to trust something can be.
In there? Let's sit up. Time to take your temp. Open up, Rambo. There you go.
You're in my bedroom. I'm wearing sleepy sores.
Try not to talk, Shortcake. I know that's hard for you. There we go. 102.8.
Oh, that's not very nice, Mr. Thermometer. Are you laughing? Oh, must be hallucinating.
Sit tight. I'll be back.
No, there's two of you. Josh must have gotten wet after midnight.
Lucy? I'm a doctor. How are you feeling?
Not so good.
She got a fever of 103.
All right, let's sit you up.
Okay. You are really handsome.
Thank you. People always say Josh is the good-looking one.
Oh, you're his brother. Oh, you must have wanted to beat him up so much when you were a kid.
I like her.
Oh, she's very special.
Wait, can you tell me embarrassing things about him? You must know all the best stuff.
Well, he used to dress up like a dog, no. Make our mom walk him around the block.
Oh, my God. This is the best day of my life.
I was a kid. Thank you.
He was 12.
No. Oh, Josh, that's too old.
All right. Thank you very much for the house call, doctor. Time to go. Laughter is the best medicine, right?
No. Did all the right things. You're even good at this. I'm not trying to be a dick. Come on. Just saying you did good. So, you ever gonna RSVP? It's just a, you know, 9980 final headcount.
Yeah, I've just been slammed at work. Sorry.
Look, man, it's awkward. I get it. When your brother gets married, you show up. Bring a plus one.
Oh, yeah, right, because that's what we need. More witnesses to our absurd family drama.
Keep your fluids up. Call me if the fever gets worse.
Thank you, Pat.
Thank you, little brother.
How are we doing?
Hey.
I brought you a little water.
I'm not a baby.
You already broke two glasses earlier, so better safe than sorry. There you go.
My mom always gave me strawberry juice when I was sick. What did yours do?
Oh, they were always too busy treating other people. If you weren't in cardiac arrest, your ailment didn't exactly rank.
Is your whole family doctors?
No surgeons. Except me.
Has anyone ever told you that you look like a young Dennis Quaid?
I think it's time to take your temp again, Shortcake.
No, stop calling me that.
Oh, not a chance. Watching you pretend to hate that nickname is the best part of my day.
You changed shirts. Look like an old Navy model.
My brother brought it for me. You puked on the other one, remember?
Oh, yeah. Dove gray, white, powder blue, window pane, true blue.
What's that?
Your shirts. Always in the same order.
I guess I am that predictable.
Yeah, you only surprised me once.
When was that?
The elevator.
And what did you think about that?
Yeah, I thought it was really hot. Are we playing the steering game?
It's my favorite.
I like the way you look at me.
Get some rest.
Josh.
Oh, she lives.
Why are you cleaning my apartment?
Oh, actually, I didn't clean it. I demoed the whole thing and rebuilt it from the ground up with a team of elves. Figured it was easier.
Okay, just because I'm not turned on by the smell of cleaning supplies.
Weird. That doesn't sound like thank you.
No.
But you're very welcome.
Thank you. Seriously, thank you for everything. But just, would you stop. This is weird. This is way too weird. Oh, and if you use any of this against me.
Oh, right, because knowing the consistency of your vomit is really going to give me a competitive edge.
No, just stop.
No, I get it. It's fine. My brother left a prescription for you on the table. See you at the office.
Shit.
So daisies are found on every continent except Antarctica. Oh, gotta go. Lucy!
Hi. What are you doing here?
I got you these.
Always with the flowers. You're very sweet.
How are you feeling?
Like my body survived a violent alien abduction.
Fun fact about alien abductions, not violent. They get a bad rap because of all the probe stuff, but My personal feelings are that aliens are actually people from like a million years from now just checking in on their ancestors. I don't know if you've read Nick Bostrom's simulation hypothesis, but if you build a quantum computer the size of a planet, essentially that, if you just... Ooh, and after you. If you think about the exponential rate of computing power alone from like 40 years ago till now, and then you do that from like 4,000 years or 4 million years, there's basically no way we're not aliens.
It's cool.
It's crazy, right?
Yeah.
Hey, so you want to get dinner tonight?
Maybe. I'll have to see how I'm feeling.
Hey, JTT. Temple man. What's up, dude, bro?
You don't work here anymore.
Yeah. Just checking in on my girl. Mm-hmm. The old Lucy Goose. Lucille Ball and Chain. Lucy in the sky with Danny. Wow. Okay. No vibe, huh?
Lucy, can you come see me when you get settled?
Yeah, just one second.
Guess that's my cue.
Oh. Thanks. Yeah, I'll email you.
Okay, cool. Go.
Strawberry juice. You sent the roses.
Joshua Templeman. Yes, I'll be right there. Thank you. Glad you're feeling better.
I saw you submitted your application.
I know, it's a long shot.
Are you kidding me? I'm counting on you getting this job. We can't let Bexley turn this place into some kind of
commercial shithouse.
I was gonna say factory, but yeah. Josh submitted his application too.
I know.
His Harvard MBA won't hurt his chances.
I have a master's in Victorian Lit. Does that count?
For me it does. Not so much for the money people. There are a lot of good candidates, Lucy.
Will you be honest with me? How much of a shot do I have? Because I really want this job and I need to prepare myself.
Don't underestimate yourself. You already coordinate every department on my behalf. You know this company from the bottom up. You have fantastic instincts. Frankly, I should have promoted you to editorial years ago.
Why didn't you?
You never asked. And I rely on you to do the parts of my job that I hate doing. Which is why you'd make a great managing director.
I'm trying to say thank you.
No need.
You helped me, okay? And I owe you a favor. What can I do for you? I will clean your apartment. I will bake you a cake. I will go with you to your brother's wedding, and I will be your designated driver. You can get shit-faced drunk, and I will clean up your vomit.
How do you know about that?
Because I overheard you in my kitchen, and I know you need a plus one. Are you mad at me?
I'm not mad at you. I'm just busy. My God, Lucinda, can I please get a moment alone?
No, not until you say we're even.
What do you mean, even? This is cozy.
Just say that I can take you to the wedding.
Is that what you want?
No, what I want is to stop fighting. I want just a tiny sliver of peace in my daily life.
And to die very slowly of boredom.
Oh, no, I won't be bored. I'll have this fantastic new job to keep me occupied.
You're not getting the job.
No. Put your hands on me.
Put them on yourself. Favor?
What?
Go to dinner with Danny and kiss him.
What? Why?
If it's better than our elevator kiss, then fine. But if it's not...
What is with you?
I don't want to be some experiment before you settle down with Mr. Wright. And I'm not going to put my hands on you again unless you tell me that nobody kisses you like I do.
Hi.
This view is incredible. This is very romantic.
Well, not just romantic, historical. Did you know that in the American Revolution, the British used to keep prisoners of war on a boat in the East River, and like 12,000 of them died. And they didn't know what to do with the bodies, so they just dumped them overboard. I mean, literally picture that in your mind.
Oh, I am. So anyway, how's business going?
Yeah, it's going all right. I got like 4 clients and pitching 2 more this week. And you know, if you get that promosh.
Yes, I will definitely keep you in mind.
Hey, I got something for you.
Danny, that's so thoughtful.
Check this out.
A business card.
For all your graphic design needs.
Thank you.
Designed it myself.
Hey, have you ever thought about kissing me?
Only every day since you spilled coffee on my lap in my first staff meeting.
You think he's home? What, are you stalking me, Shortcake?
Yeah, just went through your garbage, actually.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Find anything interesting?
You know, the usual stuff. Food scraps, stiff Kleenex, adult diapers. You should always laugh.
You should always be funny. So how was your date? Did he roll the last meatball over to you with his nose? Did you kiss him?
Yeah.
And?
And I am not going to date him anymore.
Because
nobody kisses me like you did.
Oh my God.
What?
That sound you just made.
Hey, you can invite me inside. I mean, it's only fair. I showed you mine. Wow. I really like it. Halfway expected you to live underground, near the Earth's core.
You want to snoop?
No.
You want to snoop? I snooped at your place.
Yeah, that's because my place is like a flea market compared to this. Where's all your junk?
I like a clean space.
I kind of thought once you got me up here, you were gonna ravish me.
Making you a tea instead.
Something stronger. I like your Matchbox car collection. It's like you were an actual child once. Wait, you have a single Bexley book here. Oh my God, you are a gamin.
I'm not a gamin. I just prefer gamin books.
You are such a gamin. Whoa, you really like to read about dicks.
Well, knowledge is power. No, I actually went to medical school for a year.
Oh my God, that's why Bexley calls you Dr. Josh.
To remind me of my failure to live up to my potential.
You know, if you were a doctor, all of your lady patients would have astronomical heart rates.
Hmm. Let's test that theory, huh? Mm-hmm. Imagine I'm sliding a stethoscope inside your shirt.
Oh. Me a new kink.
Pounding heart, raging case of horny eye. I think your condition may be serious.
Will I die?
A few days in bed should cure it.
Oh my gosh, I want to see your bedroom. Oh,
Oh, I love the color.
It's Benjamin Moore Calypso Green.
Very specific. Mm-hmm. Come here. Truth or dare?
Truth?
No. Oh, I was kind of hoping you'd say dare.
I'm sorry to disappoint.
Why did you quit med school?
After two semesters, my dad thought it'd be a good idea for me to spend a day in the coroner's wing. Mm. 5 minutes in, I puked inside a dead guy's stomach.
Oh my God, I would still be having nightmares. Okay, so what's this muscle called?
Brachioradialis.
Hmm. And this?
Anterior deltoid.
What about this
one? Biceps.
Oh, yeah. I knew that. Well, what about this one? Hi.
Hi.
Please remind me to write a thank you note to your personal trainer.
I just spend a lot of time in the gym. Being forced to look at you for 8 hours a day leaves me with a lot of excess energy I have to work off.
Well, I can help you burn some calories.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. How would you do that?
Well, I think we should play a very special game. It's called Who Can Make the Other Come First.
Okay.
Seriously, Josh, I just think we should have sex and just get it out of our system.
Right.
And then we can go back to normal without all this crazy sexual tension.
All right, shortcake. I think it's getting late.
What? But I just offered you sex. And, like, very enthusiastic sex.
And I appreciate it. Maybe some other time.
Maybe some other time? That's what you say when you turn down a muffin, not sex. Is this about the job?
Yeah, probably is unwise to sleep with the competition.
Right, get me to beg for sex and then kick me out of your apartment. Nice move, Templeman.
You were begging.
That's not funny. Are you toying with me?
I think you're the one playing games here, Luz.
All right, well, whatever this is, I don't want to do it anymore.
Sleep.
Not great.
Period?
What? No, I just... Oh, no. Thanks. I already ate.
This kid is... Josh, there you are. I've been looking all over for you. I'd like you to meet my good friend Simon.
Simon Mitchell.
From HarperCollins.
Josh is a Harvard man too, you know.
A few decades after me, but the crimson runs deep, am I right?
Roll Tide.
That's Alabama.
Oh.
Simon knows half the hiring panel personally. I'm sure that he'd be willing to write you one hell of a recommendation.
I'd appreciate that.
Let's talk about it over lunch.
I'll clear my schedule.
Oh, this is Lucy Hinton?
No, it's Hutton.
You sure?
Yeah. Yeah, so I thought maybe you could write me a recommendation. Yes, it was 10 years ago. H-U-T-T-O-N? Oh, you know, the color-coded filing system? I did that. No, of course it's digital now. Sure. Sure. Okay, well, if you can remember anything at all, okay, thank you. Bye. So I really need to nail this presentation. I'm thinking I can probably pay you $300 for the graphics. I know that that's not much.
Sure. I'll consider it an investment in the future of our working relationship.
Great.
Hey, so just to be totally clear, there's no chance for anything else, right? Yeah. Say no more. Your loss. I'm a world-class cuddler.
I believe that.
So, you and Dude Man, what's his bucket? Josh.
Still mortal enemies.
Hmm. I mean, don't take this the wrong way. I just figured y'all would be, like, knocking boots at this point.
Nope. Pistols and swords at dawn.
Given the choice, I go pistol 100% of the time. Significantly more effective.
Pour fêter l'hiver, la neige est tombée, blanche immaculée, sur notre maison, et tous réunis autour du grand feu. On attend minuit pour chanter joyeux. Ding-dang-dang.
Yo ho ho.
Who let you in the building?
Oh, I scaled the wall using my elite Navy SEAL training. The neighbor let me in.
What are you doing here?
Picking you up. For my brother's wedding?
Yeah, not likely, Templeman.
Look, I'm sorry about the other night. You caught me off guard.
This thing is just too complicated. All right, we are competing for the same job. We've turned mutual sabotage into an art, so it is impossible to trust each other. Also, you're like the man version of Icy Hot. Are you cold? Are you warm? Is this tingling sensation nice, or is it deeply uncomfortable?
Tingling sensation?
Okay, you know what I mean.
Look, I can't go to this thing alone, and they're expecting you to come with me. And don't forget, you still owe me. I'll be in the car.
Okay, so what do I need to know about your family?
My mom's great. That she'll love you and tell you that she wants to keep you forever. My dad is, complicated. Last time I was home, we had a fight.
What about?
A lot of things. My leaving med school, he won't let that go. My girlfriend had just broken up with me, and he and my brother were just being assholes about it.
So hard to imagine you with a girlfriend. I always pictured you as a swipe right, let's not put a label on it, babe, kind of guy.
Well, sometimes you're wrong.
It's gonna snow.
How do you know that?
Because it's a thing. I can smell weather.
Well, that would make you the lamest X-Man ever.
Whoa, hi.
How can I help you? Joshua Templeman. I've got two rooms.
Templeman? With a T?
Yeah.
Two T's?
Just the one. And sent. Sorry, just sent an email.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Okay, and... I am so sorry.
Mm-hmm.
I only have one room.
Not Jaff?
Jaffrey. My friends call me Jaff, and... We're not there yet.
Okay. Jaffrey, I really need two rooms. Can you please help me out?
I'm sorry. I mean, I need my mom to move out, but I got two weddings this weekend, right?
I know. We're in one of them.
Oh, you're the couple. Oh, congratulations. Oh,
No. It's my brother's wedding. We're just here for it.
Yeah. Oh, well, I wish I could help you out, but think about where I'm coming from on this. I got a lot of people here.
Stop. It's fine.
Oh, it's not fine.
It's not worth ruining his day when he clearly can't do anything about it. Joffrey, thank you so much. We will take the one room.
Thank you so much. She's absolutely right. It is not worth ruining my day. Great. So you are going to be in room 216, and no keys. Everything's unlocked.
Oh, boy. Wow. You will sleep there.
Should have made you stay with Jeff and his mom. Okay, we've got a half an hour until the rehearsal dinner. You want the first shower?
Sure.
Great.
Took you long enough.
Oh, I was shaving my legs.
Oh.
Flamethrower?
I like red.
So do I.
This does not mean we're okay.
Mm-hmm.
Come here. No, I want to feel your weight.
I'll crush you.
Well, I have lived a really good life.
Are you sure you're okay with this?
Oh, yeah. Let's do it.
You should write sonnets.
Best game ever.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
What?
I'm seriously late for dinner.
Just stay here.
What will your parents think? Oh, hi, Mr. and Mrs. Templeman. I'm so sorry that we missed your son's rehearsal dinner. We were too busy giving each other multiple orgasms.
I promise you, nobody will care. Let's just text them that we hit traffic and we'll see them tomorrow at the wedding.
Yeah, but what if they know we already checked in?
Why do you care so much what my parents think?
Well, it's people-pleasing 101. They are people, thus I want to please them.
But why?
Well, I already explained the totality of that logic. Also, why don't you care what people think?
I learned a long time ago that it's impossible to make people like you.
Yeah. I guess you're right. It's not like I'm ever gonna see them again. What are you thinking? I just wanna juice your head like a lemon.
There's no need for violence, little one. What do you want to know?
Okay. The other day, when you caught me snooping at your desk, I saw your planner.
Questionable ethics, shortcut.
Yeah, okay, I know. But there was some red marks in the margin. D's, S's, some X's. What are those? What? No! Tell me.
No.
Tell me.
D is for dress. P is for pants. S is for skirt. I make a mark when we have a fight. And an X when I want to kiss you.
Wow. You're like an OCD stalker.
Your turn.
My turn what?
You gotta tell me something I don't know about you.
Okay. When I wore that little black dress to work the other day.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I lied about having a date at the AC. I asked Danny out later that day. What? You were all smug and skeptical, and I just had this super hot sex dream about you.
I knew it!
Yeah, and then you said you were going to the bar, and I didn't want you to think I was a loser just sitting there all alone.
You wouldn't have been alone. You would have been with me.
Crooked.
No, I'm not falling for that again. Really?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. There you go.
No attempt at strangulation. Wow, you are really developing as a person.
Yeah, well, I need you alive for all the things I'm gonna do to you later.
Mm. You look gorgeous in this dress.
Thank you.
It matches your eyes.
Excuse me. Josh?
Oh, hi, Mom.
Oh, honey.
Mom, this is Lucy.
Hi. Oh, it is so nice to meet you, Dr. Templeman.
Oh, Elaine, please. I'm so glad to finally meet you.
Me too.
She is just adorable. I'm going to keep you forever.
Shall we?
You just snorted.
Yeah, I did.
Wasn't sure you're gonna make it.
Anthony, this is Josh's friend, Lucy.
Hi.
Good afternoon.
Oh. Friendly.
And these heels are like a medieval torture device. You wouldn't happen to have a joint, would you?
Oh, I wish.
Meth? Rat poison? I'll take anything.
Sadly, I am fresh out of rat poison, but congratulations.
Thank you. You're Lucy, right?
Yes.
I've been dying to meet you. Patrick says you're the reason Josh came today.
Oh, no. I'm sure that's not true.
Oh, I'm sure it is. It really did work out for the best in the end, didn't it? I mean, Josh and I were never good together.
I'm sorry, you were with Josh?
Oh my God, how did he not tell you? It really wasn't anything serious. The entire year we were together, I don't think we ever really connected.
You were together a year, like a calendar year, like a full 12 months. And then you and Patrick.
We're a much better fit in like every way. I mean, it was a little bit awkward at first, but I'm sorry. I should really go say inappropriate things to my other guests now.
No, it's fine.
Well, that nose of yours was right on.
Told you it was a thing.
Lucy, I hope...
Is she the reason you brought me here?
No. No, Lucy, it had nothing to do with her.
Well, why didn't you tell me?
I don't know. I was embarrassed.
Why? Hey, you did nothing wrong. They are the ones that should be embarrassed.
You know, the weekend that I got my MBA, my dad took Patrick fishing with two other surgeons. He said that I wasn't invited because I would have felt out of place. Patrick has always been the golden child. And so when Mindy left me for him, it just...
So today must really suck for you, huh?
Well, it could be worse. I could be here alone.
Well, the situation most definitely calls for some booze. So let's go.
No.
Just, yes.
No.
Yes.
Darling,
just in case you need.
You are the absolute worst.
Ah, where have you two been?
Outside, getting some fresh air.
Lucy, when you first met Josh, what did you think?
Oh. Well, I thought he was very good looking, cold, domineering, and freakishly uptight.
Oh. I thought that you had to have ambition to be domineering.
Anthony.
I'm kidding.
And I thought Lucy was very smart, but she was also a spineless kiss-ass.
Yeah, it was hate at first sight.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
Dad, it's your cue.
That's my cue.
Yeah.
Elaine wrote down a few ideas, but I think I'll wait. Oh. I always expected a great deal from my son, and he has never disappointed me. Excelled in med school, and he's become a very fine physician. It's been a privilege to watch him grow into the man he is today. Son and father can be proud of. But of all the good decisions that Patrick has made, marrying Mindy is definitely his best. Welcomes his family. Hear, hear.
It's for Christmas. The tree?
Oh, you don't say.
I brought it in from outside. It looks like it grew in here, but that tree grew outside.
Elaine.
Hi.
Hi.
Have you seen Josh?
I think he went to go find an aspirin. He said he had a bit of a headache.
Anthony probably should have gone with my prepared remarks. I'm glad you're here. Josh has been talking about you for months.
Oh, God. I cannot even imagine what he's told you. I swear I'm not that bad.
He told me that you drive him crazy and that you challenge him and that you're as strong-willed as he is. You know, I thought when Mindy left him and he took that job at B&G that he had hit rock bottom, but now I think it might be the best thing that ever happened to him. And for what it's worth, I've never seen him look at anyone the way he looks at you.
Hi. Oh, there's my beautiful groom. Oh. Have you already lost your wife?
No, not yet. She's hiding in the kitchen, eating in peace. Mom, you may need to head back into the reception room. I think Dad's maybe had one too many.
Oh, once more onto the breach.
If you ask me, it's a goddamn waste. MBA from Harvard, and you spend your days running errands and licking stamps so you can flirt with some little intern.
Intern? Maybe you should take a walk.
I don't want to be a doctor. At least do something marginally noble.
Anthony.
Join the Peace Corps. Go build wells in Nigeria.
You don't think that publishing is noble? Contributing to culture?
I don't think he's making books, sweetheart. I think he's making coffee for somebody who's making books. And by the way, it's none of your business.
Don't speak to her that way.
Okay, well, since you know nothing about your son, I'll fill you in real quick. Josh is the person that our sales and finance divisions report to. They are scared shitless of him. I've seen grown men run around like ants, triple-checking their numbers because Josh always finds their mistakes.
Lucy, you don't have to. It's fine.
I'm sorry. I know I'm making a really big scene. I'm sorry. I like all of you, except you. But I can't listen to this. Oh, and for the record, Josh's boss, who is CEO in title only, is a sleazy toad who can barely tie his own shoelaces. Josh runs that place. Actually, we both do. And the only reason that B&G didn't completely implode after the merger is because Josh oversaw a reduction of the workforce by 35%, and because of him, 200 people kept their jobs. And so he's not a doctor. Who the fuck cares? He's smart. Your son is tough, and he has made me a lot better at my job by having to compete with him. Don't get me wrong. Drives me absolutely insane, which is apparently hereditary. But your son is amazing. And the fact that you can't see that, that is a goddamn shame. In conclusion, congratulations to the bride and groom. Just amazing. Let's go home. Anthony, sir, it's been a real treat. Elaine, it was lovely meeting you.
So what now?
Naked time?
After naked time?
Rehydration.
Lucy, I've had a lot of women.
I seriously hope there's an end to that sentence.
I've had a lot of women tell me that I'm not the kind of guy you settle down with. I'm the one-night stand.
You think that's what I'm doing?
I hope not.
I seriously thought you hated me.
Never. Never, not for one second. And I can prove it to you. All right, you have to come in here, okay? And I'm gonna need to take this.
I thought you weren't feeling naked time. Kind of giving me mixed signals here.
We're not going to the bed. You have to stand right here.
Okay.
Now, tell me what you see.
Well, my hair's a little scraggly and my lipstick's faded.
You're perfect. Guess again.
Oh, my dress. Look, like a tree frog. What exactly does that prove?
Your dress isn't the only thing that matches your eyes.
Oh my God. Wait, did you?
How about this? Let's play a different game. The starting over game. Hi, I'm Joshua Templeman. Nice to meet you.
Hi. I'm Lucy Hutton. I am from Charlotte, Vermont, where they grow strawberries.
And because of that, I'm gonna call you Shortcake. It'll be a dead giveaway that I love you. You're freaking out.
No.
Don't freak out.
No, I I'm not prepared for this.
What do you mean?
After New Year's, one of us is gonna be out of a job. Any relationship we tried, it would be over before it started.
Well, maybe not. Maybe nobody has to quit.
No, this would never work. You know that, okay? We would kill each other.
Luce, I know you. I know that you blot your lips twice before you throw your tissue away. I know that your voice drops an octave when you get upset. I know you chew your lower lip when you're doing something you don't want to do. And I know that you're scared right now. But you don't have to be. I'm in this. And you can trust that.
Sun in my eyes, navy blue skies, you are the reason I can survive. I had a nightmare, but now that I'm not scared,
this is how you fall in love.
Dangerous time for men these days, Josh. If we don't stick together, manic pixie twits like Lucy Hutton, you're gonna be running this country on lipstick and feelings. I can tell you, I didn't start this company to have my balls crushed by some nitwit in a push-up bra. Do you hear me?
Loud and clear.
I have a vision for this company, and I'm counting on you to make it happen. So do you have a strategy? Do you have a plan?
I do. It's already underway.
I told you she'd back off if you let her think that she could pet the pony. I'm glad she took my advice. Is there anything else I can do to help you cinch this thing?
No. I don't need any help beating her.
All right, I'm sure you don't. Get on it, then.
Hey, are you free? I'm heading to the coffee shop right now.
Sexually gaslighting you?
This is diabolical.
I guess it makes sense. You're not gonna work as hard if you're crushing on him. I wonder what it's like to be a dude who uses his raw animal magnetism as a weapon.
Yeah, but it's one thing to flirt.
It's a whole other thing to pretend like you have actual feelings. I feel like such an idiot. Are you sure it's okay that we're talking about all this?
Yeah. I mean, I'm basically the mayor of the friend zone, so I'm hip. Safe space. Carry on.
I just cannot believe I let myself get played like this. I mean, he seemed so sincere.
Well, fear not, my sweet friend. You are going to nail that interview, get the job, and then order will be restored to the universe.
Yes. Well, justice demands that Josh live a long life alone, sucking on Bexley's nasty nuts. So.
Oh, hey, Josh.
What are you doing here?
I was looking for you. Thought I'd join you for a coffee.
I don't like you enough to get a coffee with you.
My mistake.
Solid burn.
Do we have confirmation that the Lunar Review is featuring stripping time?
CC'd you on the email.
No, I'm looking at my inbox and it's not here, you sociopath.
Well, then you're either blind or just lying as usual.
I don't lie.
You lie all the time. You just don't see it as lying because you tell people what they want to hear.
What? Name one time I've done that.
You told me you weren't interested in Danny.
Wow. That is amazing. You are actually gonna play this thing all the way through, aren't you? And see, that's what I don't get. Throw me off my game, fine. Flirt with me, mess with my head, whatever. But why would you want to keep me from dating someone else? Danny is nice.
And I'm not.
I thought you were. Somewhere under the layers of psychological damage, but it turns out you would just do whatever it takes to win and make your daddy proud. And you know what? I am so glad that I threw up all over you because I am this close to doing it again.
What is wrong with you?
I hurt you with Bexley.
And?
And I bet if he knew you'd had a hand all the way up my skirt, he'd throw a parade in your honor.
That's not
Josh,
what
Josh, Josh, Josh. I'm gonna need those projections on my desk by Friday.
I don't have the time. Lucy can do it.
Hutton. Care to grow some hair on your nuts and step up?
You know, Richard, I would love to, but I doubt a nitwit in a push-up bra would be much help to you.
Josh, projections on my desk Friday.
There is no way in hell I am letting you and Bexley destroy this place. Have a call at 2 with TLS, unless you want me to take it. I know the catalog.
It's all yours.
Wait, do you know where Josh is?
I haven't seen him since yesterday.
That's weird, right? The week of the presentation, he's up to something.
I wouldn't put it past him. You ready for this?
Hell yes. I will bring my A game.
That's what I like to hear.
My boyfriend's niece, Daisy, the one I told you about for the internship.
This is Daisy.
Like the flower.
No. Absolutely not.
No, but you said that.
I got steamrolled, and you know it. I'm sorry. You seem like a lovely girl, but you actually couldn't have picked a worse time. And you still haven't turned in your monthly report.
Oh, yes. I wanted to talk to you
about it. No, don't worry about it. I already talked to Alan. I got the numbers, and I did the report myself. Again.
Oh, you're such an angel.
No, I'm not an angel. I'm a patsy, and I am done. It's a migraine or a sprained wrist. I mean, 3 months ago, you couldn't turn in the report because a bird flew into your face coming off the subway and you were too distraught to concentrate.
It was a big bird.
And while I sympathize with your various plights...
You don't sound sympathetic. She doesn't sound sympathetic.
I'm gonna have to ask you to do your job.
I'm disappointed in you.
Well...
Impressive.
Thank you. Not that I... need your validation.
Thank you for coming. Lucy Hutton, you're up next.
Okay. One thing. If you get this job, are you actually gonna let Bexley gut the literary department?
It's his business. He can do what he wants with it.
Okay. That's all I needed to know. This is the first chapter of a new book from best-selling author Emily Powery. I propose creating a cross-media platform so that people can download ebooks or audiobooks and then have conversations with other readers and the writer.
How would that work?
Well, once you finish a chapter, you are then directed to a community group to discuss the story, and the writer is part of that community. They publish a chapter at a time, like the old 19th century serials, and then join the conversation with the readers before they write the next chapter.
Interesting.
If you turn to section 2 of the document in front of you, you will see the budget that I'm proposing. They seriously grilled me on the numbers, but I think I held my own.
Sure, you blew them away.
And I have to say, whether or not I get this job, this whole thing, it did kind of wake me up.
Well, here's a little something.
Oh my God. A peacock edition? Helen? Oh, it's beautiful.
Mr. Darcy, such a great romantic hero. Inscrutable, misunderstood.
I don't know. I think she might be setting up a false expectation. Sometimes, guy's just an asshole.
That's certainly been my experience.
It's gonna look nice in your library.
It's a great promotion for you.
Thank you.
Lucy, we were just about to come find you.
Congratulations. You earned it.
Well, Paul had a big decision to make today. I think it goes without saying that this merger has been a little bumpy, but I think that B&G is positioned now to become a major literary powerhouse. I know firsthand that no one is more savvy or tenacious than its new managing director, Lucy Hutton. Congratulations, Lucy.
Way to go, Luz.
What? Wait, but she just said that...
I took a job as acquisitions editor at HarperCollins last week.
Son of a bitch.
So when you said you didn't need help beating me...
It's because I had decided to resign.
Why didn't you tell me?
That would be my fault. I begged him not to say anything. I am sorry, Lucy. Just fighting with Josh lit such a fire under you. I knew if you kept that drive, you'd beat everyone else and get the job.
She would have kicked your ass too, Josh.
Fair enough. Luz, you are the heart and soul of this place, and everybody knows it.
Just what the company needs. More heart and soul.
Richard, shut up. In fact, always just keep your mouth shut as a general rule.
Hey. You're fired.
Already quit, jackass.
You know what I just realized?
What's that?
You are the nice guy.
You take that back.
No.
Where are you off to?
Weekend at the Cape. See you on Monday or Thursday.
No, no, no. We have a contract with O'Brien, so if he wants to switch publishers, you're going to have to buy him out. Will you hold on a second? This has a year's worth of sexual harassment claims against Richard Bexley. Give it to the board. Thanks. That is due Wednesday.
So it turns out love and hate aren't as similar as I thought.
Yeah, well, our legal team would beg to differ.
Sure. They both get your blood pumping and make you want to do crazy things to someone else's body.
Shove it up your semicolon.
No, 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 no.
Think 30% higher.
But when you love someone, and I mean really love someone, even when you fight, you're still on the same team.
Look, if you want to poach one of our writers, you're going to take a bath while doing it.
Interesting. You know, I think I'm going to need a few more details on that particular proposal.
You should know that I never mix business with pleasure.
Never?
Hi.
Hi.
How's your day?
Oh, there's this new exec over at B&G. She's being a real hard ass.
Bitch.
Yours?
Oh, there's a snake at HarperCollins who's trying to steal one of our best writers.
Oh, shortcake. You want me to beat him up for you?
No. I don't want you fighting anyone but me.
I know your mind, I'm yours until the end.
gonna give no hate. Keep me right, keep your word, even though truth can hurt. We prefer that to lies and know me well, hold me tight. When it's dark, show me light. Baby, we can make it if we only worry about the right things. About the right things, we'll be alright. We'll be alright, yeah. All we got is, all we got is us. That's all we need, that's all we need. And we'll be okay as long as we just stay 100, honey. Just stay 100, honey. Just stay 100, honey. Just keep it real with me and I'll be.